tell you something. All that glitters ain't gold.
Hey, hey.
It's been a long old trouble, long old troublesome road. And I'm looking for somebody. Come and help me carry this load. I need a dollar, dollar, dollar. That's what I need.
Hey, hey.
Well, I need a dollar, dollar.
Protecting consumers. Counterfeit products can harm consumers. They're often of inferior quality, and they certainly oftentimes do not meet safety standards. And so the Dominican Republic, by fighting these counterfeits, can ensure that customers are protected from a lot of risks. And we're going to talk about this right after this message. And welcome back to Dominican Rendezvous. Thank you for joining the channel today. You could be doing anything else, anywhere else, but you've decided to join me here at Dominican Rendezvous, and I am appreciative of it. You'll just take a quick moment. If you haven't done so already, please subscribe to the channel, as well as hit the notification bell for any new videos that may come out and come your way in the near future. We're putting out video content 2 or 3 times a week, so you want to make sure you get it for the best information on things and happenings in the Dominican Republic. If you make it to the end of the video, please take a moment to hit the like button. I would appreciate that as well. Today I want to talk about counterfeiting in the Dominican Republic. And over the past several years, the Dominican Republic government and the relevant authorities within the Dominican Republic, in my opinion, have been doing a great job in making lots of headway in the counter activity of counterfeiting in the Dominican Republic. We know it's a worldwide issue. It's not exclusive to the Dominican Republic. There's a host of other countries, particularly in Europe and Russia, that are involved in counterfeiting issues. This issue does not affect only the Dominican Republic or the United States, but again, it is a worldwide issue. It affects a country's economy. It can affect the people's health within that country, as well as their security. Keep in mind, a lot of time, what you see is not what is necessarily behind the counterfeiting. Because behind counterfeiting, there is a whole network of criminal activity. There's drug trafficking, money laundering, crime, and even possible terrorism as well. And we all know that these vices, as I've said many, many times, are bad for society. So today I just want us to keep in mind a few things. And the first thing that we keep in mind is that we know where the Dominican Republic is located. It is a geographical hot spot for the transference and the logistics of for the drug trade. Yet at the same time, it is a popular tourist destination, and therefore this makes it an ideal spot for counterfeiting activity. You could take a cruise around the major metropolitan cities like Santiago, Santo Domingo, and you'll quickly find some locations where counterfeit products are basically sold and sold really pretty much out in the open. These days, more and more, you can see the items being sold on social media and on social networks like Instagram and Facebook, where they're being used to advertise and sell counterfeit products. So this crime is not only present in the streets or in physical stores, but it is also available and used primarily through online and virtual. There are fake medicines being sold, which also pose a risk for a person's health. And so people have got to be careful with this. Particularly if you are traveling to the Dominican Republic and you may need to get some medication, you want to make sure that you are getting authentic medication. A couple years ago, you remember the problem the Dominican Republic had, and it still has to a certain extent, with adulterated alcohol, fake alcohol, and as I mentioned just before, medicines. They're well known to be transmitted or transferred into the Dominican Republic through Haiti, where they're smuggled across the Dominican borders. and authorities have been finding labs and places where the stuff is made, and they've closed them down, they've destroyed them, and dismantled them, all in the effort to curb the crimes. Though the task may have been and seems to be daunting, really, the Dominican Republic has made inroads and continues to break down those networks of criminal activity. I read on the online newspapers how much of this activity has been stopped and that they are going after it hardcore. We know that the thievery of someone's original ideas is a terrible form of robbery, especially in the fashion industry, in the clothing industry. Many designer brand originators, they spend a lot of time and a lot of money on trying to create something new, something distinctive, something original, designs in their fashions to make a name for themselves and to make their trademark, their brand name. But unfortunately, many do not give much care to the prevention of these counterfeits and the enforcement of counterfeiting of luxury goods and clothing. Most people don't really give a rat's ass or care about it. It's a minor crime, they say. And, you know, something that they're really not really worried about. Some say counterfeits actually even assist in branding and marketing of a brand, and that there is no real profit loss. And I guess that's an argument that could be made, but it still remains to be seen. Counterfeit luxury goods, brands, is a big business, especially in Europe, but has a presence here in the Dominican Republic. Many counterfeits are seen in this country, from Calvin Klein, Ralph Lauren, Timberland, etc., Nike. What you see generally is, or I should say are, labels that have been sewn onto cheap garments, cheap fabrics, such as shirts, jeans, t-shirts, bags, so forth. It is common to see large batches of plain clothes, primarily imported from China and Panama, where they put labels on them at the last minute, basically to try to avoid detection. And it is pretty easy to detect the counterfeits. You can go online, and there are a lot of places where you can get information on how to spot counterfeit goods. I remember really quickly when I was in Korea for my first time back in 84. And they had a place there, it's called Itaewon, and that was sort of a market area for people, military men basically, who were stationed in Yongsan. But obviously travelers and tourists would go there to go shopping. And I remember very well, almost like yesterday, buying knockoff fake Izod Lacoste polo shirts and fake Nike sweatpants and things of that nature. And the moment you took them home, the moment you washed them, the colors would bleed, they would lose shape, they would fall apart. I kid you not. And that's one of the ways that you know something, obviously, is a counterfeit. It falls apart, it loses shape, color fades, all of that. These days, it has been much harder to distinguish between a fake. Some material, I'm told, the material itself is not counterfeit, but the manufacturers who are selling that same material to the original brand designers are selling it also on the backside, and then they're able to put fake labels on it to make it look as though it's original, especially for items like Calvin Klein. Same thing for perfumes and colognes as well. Many are sold in the gray market or the black market through street traders, small shops, even as I mentioned already online, at these super bargain prices. Most of these vendors, most of these sellers would have you to believe, rather than it being fake, that it was actually, let's say, misplaced or stolen, and therefore you have the real deal, and they're trying to deceive you in that way. But you can identify them pretty easy. You just look at the fake packaging. Many things look similar to the original, but they're not identical to the original. There are cheap replicas that are out there with false origin, so you need to really check into those things. One more item that I'll mention really quickly is this adulterated alcohol. Some establishments, as you recall, back around the COVID times, or just before COVID, I guess it was, there were a lot of bars, restaurants, resorts that were purportedly using fake adulterated alcohol, and people were getting sick. A lot of tourists were getting sick. You can go back and read some of that. I think I did some videos on that as well. But one of the things that you have to do, for those of you who do drink and who do imbibe in alcohol, when you get your alcohol, you better do some good checking to make sure that the cap is a tight-fitting cap. There is no leaks. It doesn't just simply sit on top and rotate, but that it is actually sealed. It's one way you can check to make sure you're getting something that's authentic. Not the only way, but you need to compare the bottles with other bottles to make sure that the fill lines are identical. If you see a bunch of bottles in which one is filled at this level, another is filled at that level, another is filled at this level, you can be pretty sure there's something fishy going on. The other thing is to turn the bottle around a couple of times, shake the bottle a little bit if you can, and watch how the bubbles rise. See if you see any particles start to fall down. If you start seeing some particles or sediment or what appears to be sediments falling down, you can be sure that there's something probably wrong with that bottle of alcohol. But again, there's a lot of other items as well to be careful with. The footwear, the cell phone, accessories, toys, all of the stuff you will see being counterfeited in the Dominican Republic. Now, those that do work in that trade and are busy making money in that trade, there are fines and prisons if you get caught that will be leveled. The Dominican Republic has a prison sentence, if you will, from 6 months to 3 years if you're caught and found guilty. They're always passing laws to try to crack down on the issue. They're joining world organizations as well to try to show and to, you know, get more information on how to protect these brand originators and to stop counterfeiting. The government itself has actually put together new prosecutor teams in place to go after criminals who do this. They're confiscating, they're destroying products all over the country once they have determined it to be fake. The bottom line is this, is that counterfeiting is a crime and affects all parts of society. It affects society's health, it affects society's economy. Poor quality goods are sold at prices that seem to be good deals, but who in fact is benefiting? It is the counterfeiter that is profiting unfairly off others. And as I mentioned, those companies that are being copied, their ID has been stolen from them, they put in good efforts to make a good name, it's a good work and a good product. But when these counterfeiters come along, it hurts their business. It hurts small business. It hurts entrepreneurs. In a sense, it also damages the economy by a loss in sales for other businesses that are actually hiring folks who want sales. Actually, do the simple economics. Once the sales fall, the people lay off, and then you lose jobs. There are job losses, lower wages, and then eventually higher prices for all. So counterfeiting is not a victimless crime. Now again, as I mentioned, in summary, it happens everywhere. I get it. It's nothing that's special or unique to the Dominican Republic. I get it. But I just want to make sure that we keep our eyes open and keep our eyes on the swivel, so to speak, that what we buy, where we buy it, how we buy it, can make a difference here in the Dominican Republic. From me to you, Dominican, well, Robin. Dollar, 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 that's what I need. Hey, hey. Said I need dollar, 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 that's what I need. And if I share with you my story, would you share your dollar with me? Bad times are coming and I reap what I done sowed. Hey, hey. Well, let me tell you.